for polynomial which is a classical additive number theory problem. In particular, I'm interested in asymptotic order, which is explained later. But since the evaluation of asymptotic order is, need many analytic computation, today I skip the calculation. As you know, many elementary number theory problem or additive number theory problem are easy to understand. Also, it's my talk. It's easy to understand. First, I state Lagrange theorem. And consider it, it's a generalization. After that, I explain a circle method, which is necessary in solving Wellin problem, and review a known result. Finally, I share with you the Gaepp works. Gaepp work. And apply its work to some polynomial. Yes. As you know, in 1770, Lagrange proved the following theorem. Before that, a French mathematician Pache, right? Yes. Theorem is only a state. Lagrange proved this theorem. Every non-negative integer can be written as a sum of whole scale. It is very famous and classical theorem. To generalize Lagrange theorem, let me define polygonal number. Polygonal number is defined like this. For a triangular number, first triangular number is 1, second triangular number, is 3, third triangular number, six, and so on. For a square number, first also 1, second 4, third 9, and so on. Pentagonal number
but also one. Second, five. By a similar procedure, one can define nth Kangon Kangon number. Kangon number. P sub K of N. The number is N plus K minus 2. Cauchy proved the following theorem, which is called the polygonal number theorem. Written as a sum of k Kangon number. This polygonal number theorem this is a is a horizontal generalization of Lagrange theorem. The case k k equal 4 is the case of Lagrange theorem 4.
Triangle and the square, but can you
only two is a line. This is plane.
That's right. Yeah. It's
a little meaningless.
Yeah. Because for k is equal to 2, it's just going to be 1, 2, and 3, and 4, so it's just going to be all integers. So.
Yes. Right. We need another definition. A is subset of set of natural number, set of non-negative integer. A is basis of order G. Order G means if G is the minimum. Number with the property that every non-negative integer measure
can be
written as a sum of G element and A.
By this definition, a set of a square number is a basis of order 4. By Lagrange theorem is this order less than equal to 4, but 7 cannot be written sum of 3 square, so it's a basis of order 4. By similar reason, is this is order of K. In 7070, wearing a state without proof that every non-negative integer can be written as a sum of whole square and sum of 9 cube, sum of 19 fourth power. And so on. So wearing problem is set up a representation of non-negative integer as a sum of kth power.
So my stupid question is this. So Lagrange proved this in 1770. So Waring actually conducted this one in the same year following Lagrange's theorem?
I don't know the Waring know that yeah, same years. Yeah.
And actually, Cauchy proved this problem.
Yes. Hilbert first gave a non-trivial result for Waring problem. Set of kth power is a basis of final order for every positive integer k. Finite means for given k is basis has a finite number. This is classical rotation. Smallest order. It's denoted by G of K. This theorem means this value is finite. Known results. G of 2, 4, G of 3, 9, G of 4, 19, G of 5, 37, G of 6, 73, and so on. G of 2 equal 4 means, set of, sum of 3 squares is not G. We have a natural question. What is a set of sum of 3 squares? And sum of 2 squares. Euler and Gaussian gave a result. Answer the question. First, Euler gave the answer. So, if and only if. Each prime factor of M congruent to 3 마줄로 4. 4 on even power in the prime factorization in M. Gauss gave an answer for second question. If and only if, Gauss. M is not of the form. By this answer, we note that there are infinitely many which cannot be a written sum of square, sum of 3 square.
Next, we consider
the lower bound of g of k. This proof, since this proof is very, very simple, let me show you. Consider the number this number is less than 3 to the k. So this number can be only represented by 1 to the k and 2 to the k. This number k so it's very simple. But this is very important. The surprising fact is the exact value of g of k is almost this number. It's called Euler conjecture. Less than equal to this number. It's true, but it's still think about further generalization of Euler problem. Fx is integer valued polynomial. Integer valued polynomial means the coefficient fx can be rational, but the value of fx is only integer. That's the equation. G of F is defined by
Yes. Yes. Large shear web is defined by least value. Oh, star. Which star is solvable? Sufficiently large integer. All sufficiently large integer and means it is the least value of S which star is solvable for all number n with at most a finite number. Of exception. So, this is classical rotation. G of 2 is 4.
Small g is 4, large g is 3.
Large g of also 4. This means, as I said before, there are infinite many can be written cannot be written somewhat 3 square. All the exact value of g of x to the k's power we know are only 2. For the other case is there exists only upper bound and a lower bound. Conjecture. I am interested in this large g for some polynomial. Linick gave a result for result of a Wheeling problem for integer valued polynomial. Let fx be integer valued polynomial such that of GCD of fx is 1.
second condition, this sequence has strict inclusion. Then the finite order. In general, small g, finite order, small g, and asymptotic order large g are very large. They have exponential growth. I want to find a set which has exponential growth, small of g and large g. So,
I have a stupid question. So, is it possible to make the problem a little bit easier by considering the varying problem for integers that are sufficiently large? So, if n is representable by the sum of the f of n.
You mean contain a minus?
No, what I mean is if the varying problem is true for all but finitely many numbers, then.
Exception, final number exception,
right.
Yes.
Maybe, can we possibly make the problem easier? I mean, certainly easier to do the problem, but I'm just.
Yes, it may theoretically exist, yes.
It seems like a strictly increasing function is a very strict condition.
Yes.
So, if it is sufficiently large n, if it's. Strictly increasing, then we are basically solving the finite exceptional case of the varying the problem. But for that case, maybe it's easier.
This condition is very strict, but integer valued polynomial class of integer valued polynomial is very large, but we consider only this polynomial.
Right. Yeah. Well, I think there is a general theorem which is saying that all integer valued polynomial can be written as a linear combination of the binomial coefficients.
Yes, yes, yeah.
And actually, actually, we can see that very few are going to be satisfying strictly. I mean, if it's actually beyond a certain level, then it is going to always strictly increasing. So basically, number 2 is going to be satisfied by almost all of the polynomials if it is weakened by the condition, like a sufficiently large n. But if we insist this one, maybe this is only this thing to be able to find even some kind of function.
It doesn't, and this is doesn't matter, I think. Important thing is a finite number. Yes.
So you are looking for g of f, so that basically it doesn't really matter. Big g of f is what you are looking for. So that
yes.
I see. So you can actually say that this is strictly increasing function for all sufficient.
I see.
So you're not looking for small g of f, but you're looking for big g of f.
Big g, yes.
Okay.
So I reduce a class of set of integer valued polynomial. Polyte number. Plato number has a very good geometric structure and a very good structure property. Roughly speaking, Plato number higher dimensional analog log of polygonal number. My advisor, Professor Hyungwang Kim, gave several talks for how to construct a Plato number and the property of for Plato number. In this talk, I skip the detailed explanation for Plato number. Anyway, there exists a third kind of Plato number. This is k dimensional simplex Plato number. Second, quite complicated. K-dimensional cross Plato. Gamma K of N is the simplest form of this in three Plato number n to the k. Dimensional major Plato. My goal is to calculate Wheeling problem for this three kind of polynomial. To do it, we need a circle method. Yes. This number is yes. This in the direction is horizontal generalization. This. This number is this. Yes, this number is
N cube, yes. M to the fourth, yes.
Vertical generalization. As you can see, this number is very has good geometric structure. This number. Second method gives analytic approach to study geometry. Let's consider the following generating function. G, large f of g is then f of g to the s power equal we can assume positive. Positive.
So it's not part of the definition of integer negative
where this is number of representation for n as a sum of s elements of fx. By Cauchy integral formula, over e pi I integral of d circle yes. This is the original form of the circle method introduced by Hardy, Littlewood, Ramanujan. They evaluate this integral by dividing circle of integration into two disjoint parts, minor arc part, major arc part. The integral. Minor arc, integral of, over major arc. The integral of minor arc part is negligible.
So the integral maze of part provide a main term for this R of n. There exists a modified and simplified form of this circle method. This is original form. I'll review a Bayes achievement. First, who gave exact value for exact value of large G for some polynomial using circle method. K greater than or equal to 5, then T of IG of HK is 2 to the K. This is exponential growth. Second, we consider major polytope. Yeah. There are many results for this polytope. RDN, little wood, large G of K. Pinegredo. Pinegredo reduced polynomial cross. K log K log log K. Figure of 1. Only. I think this upper bound is almost optimal. While this this lower bound has k plus 1. So it is how to reduce this bound. As you can see, it takes to remove 60 years. 60 years. Simplest number. This small j. Changing none. K log K minus K G of K G of F O or large G. Yes, large G. Small g. This small g. Yes. I think this upper bound is upper bound can be improved. Improved. Since density of this number is larger than this major polytope, so I think major polytope, this is a simplex polytope. I think so. One can reduce, improve this upper bound. How about cross polytope? To do it, I discuss the Lecaille works. Takes a polynomial with an integer coefficient. FQ is denoted by, defined by the list integer. With the following. Every
we consider the following modular equation, congruous equation. And SSSR. Q. Solution. MG. P is prime. Let me define beta of fx p noted by or defined by list non integer. Here exists P0 such that Fx M P to the beta is solvable. X 4 This is very important factor in the Kaipo work. L0 D prime GCD Yeah, something. This error term. Yes. L0. I want to apply this theorem to closed polytope. Closed polytope. Beta. Okay. By using this theorem, I obtained the following.
In this case, this question is a little quite large, so use I use a bigger notation. But this case, I can't obtain any result. So we solve this problem. We need to develop the circle method for integer valued polynomial. With rational coefficient. That's it for today.